Yeah.
What I know is the radio box is going to be in here.
Oh, radio box.
The receivers and stuff?
Yeah.
They probably didn't want the fumes from the acid in there.
They're going to be in there.
Supposed to be two of them.
See, I was wondering why they didn't stick them in the battery.
Next week, official.
But yeah.
It's a little sharp. Gives me the off.
You got lucky there, Mike.
I know I got lucky.
I mean, come on, let's face it. Who else do you think I'm putting
in?
Hausman?
I have 25 friends. Hausman's got 18 friends.
We have to roll into the dirt.
Can you grab some aspic for some rags?
Rags.
Hey, quick, we want that rest.
Oh, that one? We're cutting that one off.
What?
Bob, next year.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
You're going to have to fight me for the position.
Nah.
Not much of a fight.
Thin ones. You get the feel. You'll notice that once you start operating with this unit, a lot of it's feel. Okay? All right. Start out. Get through the seam. Through this one here. All the way over to the choke. Okay? Pull. Once you start it,
match the run.
Leave it right at run. Okay? You're going to have one man that stays with this unit at all times. Never leaves the unit. As you're right around here, you might have a guy that you'll be talking to somebody else, but at a scene, that man here watches those two guys with that, with the tools. He pays no attention to anybody else. All right, once you've got your motor started, control valves right here, you have a neutral, you have a left and a right side, red and black side, whichever way you want to call it. Every company goes different, okay? If you make it a standard procedure that you hook up the spreader to the red, this is what you're going to be using at all times now. When the guy says charge red, this way you'll always be doing the same thing, okay? Very simple system. Left, right, center. Neutral. You can let your engine be running. As long as it's in neutral, no problems at all. Never let it sit, let the tool sit there and leave it in charged position. If it happens that it's there for 15, 20 seconds or something like that, no problem. It wouldn't develop any major problem if it was even longer, but it's just a good habit to keep it right in neutral. Okay? All right, we'll move up. I'll bring it right here, this way. To grab these things, connections, quick disconnects, very simple. Either hand, whichever you prefer. You have a little pin. Take the pin, knob, back, hold it, insert, then insert far enough. Quarter turn, now step it apart. Okay? Very easy. Very easy to put together and apart. Hold, push, let go, turn. You'll feel a snap because there's a gasket in there, a rubber gasket in there that you have to snap over. Okay? Hold it. Give your lock.
Do you only do that when the line's not charged?
Definitely. Definitely. Keep everything in neutral at all times. That should not leave neutral until a man is ready to operate a tool. Okay?
That coupling, once it's moved over, it's locked, so you can't pull it out.
Once it's there, you're not going to pull this apart.
What would happen if you got charged?
Push it back, push this out, and we push it out far enough that you might lose a drop or two of oil and she'd be apart. Very rarely, when you go like this and you pull, the best thing to do is make it a standard procedure. Once you've gone like that, okay, you know it's locked now. You get it a pull. If it won't pull apart like that, it's not gonna pull apart. Okay, why don't you guys grab the other.
Faster. You got a baby to save. Hurry up. Got it in tight.
System where we have the type of connections that swivel. It used to be like the ram where they were stationary. They've now gone to this system. Seems, in a way, seems to work a lot better. It's also nice for storing the tools, makes it easier for storing the tools. There's the connections. These are your twist control, okay, either way, in and out. Now, you don't have to twist until you stop, okay? Same thing this way. You don't have to turn until you stop. You're not going to get any more if you go all the way to the point where it stops. Okay. They're a dead man control that when you turn like this, it opens 3 inches, you let go, that's where it stops. Okay. We'll show you as we start going through here, we'll put the tool under a load, we let go, disconnect. She stays right where it is, keeps it right where it is, there's no movement. After you've disconnected, you go over and go like this and she's not going to move at all. Okay? Anybody ever driven a motorcycle? It's like a motorcycle control. With actually, all you need is two fingers to control it. Use your whole hand, but it's that easy to turn. Okay? Don't need to grip on there and, you know, crank on it because it just isn't going to make it any faster. As you use it, you'll notice that you can actually feather it and make it. A lot of times you want to feather it to make it go slower instead of just cranking wide open and just tearing something apart. You want to go real slow to bring it off nice and easy. Okay. Same way, same type of controls, same type of connections. You have the point right at the base, which is for like reinforcing rods, guide wire cables, stuff like this, which it'll cut. Okay, 60,000 pounds here, 40,000 here. Okay, the blades are guaranteed for life. The only thing is, you break them here, we know what you did. Okay. They will break if you do something wrong. The wrong part is right around your nadir bolt, right around where your hinges are, you have a backing plate. Okay. Normally it's probably about a quarter of an inch thick by approximately this size. If you take and close these tips onto that backing plate, you will definitely break them. Either right here or right here. You know this is what you did. You don't want to cut anything that you can't get tips around. Okay? Unless you're cutting sheet metal. Sheet metal, there's no problem. You just take and bite into it around the post and stuff like this. The only thing you want to be careful of is that you make sure that you don't go right pointed parts of the tip against flat stock material. Okay? If you break them, we'll get you new ones. If you break them again, we're going to ask you, what are you doing? We know you're doing something wrong. You know, after about the third pair, probably the third pair, you're going to start saying, wait a minute, you're going to have to start paying for these to keep breaking. Okay? That's the only way that we break. All right? I told some of the officers in there, what you want to do when you're operating is make sure that you see this cross like this. If you've been cutting at an accident scene or something like this, and you have this against some metal, because of the movement, you could possibly turn this loose. I did it already. All right? What happened is these gray blades crossed and then went into each other. Okay? So just as a normal standard procedure when you're operating, just make sure that everything's working right. Okay, you just keep an eye on it. This is nice and tight. What we like to see is this, when these two edges come together, that you can't see daylight in here. That's cutting tightness that you want this bolt. Right, there's no actual foot torque wrench foot pounds that you have to have on it. Just making sure it is tight, that's all. Okay. Fire the spreaders. Try and spread with this part, okay? If you hit into the sheet metal with this part of the arm, no problem, okay? You just want to make sure that you're trying to do basically most of your work with this. Just to keep from nicking these up. That's basically the main reason. Okay, any questions? Yes. Yes, they're guaranteed. We had one company break them within about 4 days' time. Well, actually, within about 2 days' time,
They had a new brain spray.
Tool is at the point now, if you did something went wrong with one of the arms, what I would do is I would bring my demo for you to keep in service. All right. You just take the arm, comes off, and you would take and go back. You get a new arm, put it right back in, and you're all set to go. Okay. What we try and do, we try and leave about maybe a quarter of an inch spread between the tips. Okay. When you're storing. These tips, just like the arm, when you have finished making a cut, and it looks like you're not going to be making any more cut before she shuts it off, take the 2-3 seconds to close it like this. Because if you leave it wide open and set it down, someone's going to walk into that with their foot or something. Get a number on your foot. You could hurt yourself. All right, so you want to always keep them like this. Just for safety reasons. Okay? You didn't get the base for this. I'll show you.
Excuse me. We asked him though. That was a thing at the Snyder game.
Was the base ordered with us?
As far as I know, it didn't order with
us. Okay. You have the base, it's nice. Okay. It's a nice square metal nice square unit that fits right over top everything. Gives you a really good biting area on the car. Alright, there is very little maintenance to this. Just keep your shaft clean so it doesn't scar it up. Get it wiped off. Same control. And as far as other than that, there's just not much to it. Any questions? Nobody got any questions?
Break a hole. Just have check that internal check valve. Snap at that point, so you don't have a hose flopping around with all the pressure behind it.
It's not going to go flying.
It's got check valve.
Right. It will shut down on it. Anybody else?
I got a question for you. Are you a power unit here?
Only run one tool at one time.
Hey, Peter. You're the first one. How does it feel?
Yeah.
But you only run one tool at one time.
Mr. Jaws.
But you guys have you had a bigger Jaws in the way?
Right?
He said it was heavy. You had a bigger Jaws in the
way. Was he had
some? And Peter Tell, sorry.
Go Sweet Homer. There are all kinds of vandalism.
Can't do it.
Is that yours?
No, it's ours.
Here's Marshall's BMW.
Yeah. You really don't have to. Take the windshield out. Okay. Hold it here approximately. What you want to do is spread this, or push this together, so that it'll open this up enough to get your tips in there. Okay? So that's how we want to start out.
You got the red one. You got the red one.
Yeah, you get it under the roof and it starts to burn.
Yeah.
try and hold it. It's going to go where it wants.
You're not
going to
be able to hold.
I guarantee you that.
All right.
Well, I don't know where it wants to go.
Now, all you might have to do is try the door up first. Right. Then, come up here, try the door down. This way, take the door off at the top first. Now, you're not going to be able to control your door when you go down to the bottom. And if anything, you're going to end up driving it into the ground, lifting the car up, and you're going to have problems. So the best bet is to start at the bottom first, take the door up. You have one guy standing here holding it. Okay. 30.
file?
Just try and see if you can feel it where she, where you can feather. Gotta go a little bit more. Just take keep a wrap around it.
There you go.
Nice and easy. Telephone, Jim. In a mechanics room. Telephone.
Okay.
That's good. Just so that you can't get, you know.
We're in your neutral position right now.
Okay.
I mean, don't go to the point of taking the roof off, take the whole car apart, when all you had to do was go up here and go like this and open the door. You make a very big fool out of yourself.
Yeah.
That's right. So, you know, it's just the... Okay. I prefer coming over like this. Most of the time, I just want to show you the two different techniques.
That's two techniques, all right?
Yeah, there's one other one that I'll show you on the last car this afternoon. On this here?
Yeah.
Alright, now, let me show you something different too. He's doing fine, but you want to try, if you have the opportunity, depends on where your victim is and everything, the more that you can go like this, more where the nadir bolt is, the better off you are. Right? You don't want to try and spread like this because it's not doing you any good. You want to try and tip those blades, the tips, right to the point where most of your cars, American-made cars, nadir bolt is approximately right in here. Okay. That's what you want to aim towards. Whoop. Beautiful. Now see, you let it max out, you have this. Yeah, that's characteristic of it. I'll do it all the time with this
circumstances.
Now see, as you're waiting for that to close, you know you're going to make it. We're over here, you've got it closed. Now, there just comes with training. That's, there you go. See, the way you were, right here is where you have your chance to pick up. If it's here, I'm not going to be responsible. All you Okay? Very easy, right? It's just getting used to it, that's all. Even if you only open in a door, once you've gotten that door open, get the people out, gone, man, I'll tell you, the feeling is great. I know, because I've had two in our company that we've done that way. It's like when you take somebody that's had a heart attack or something like that, you've lost them and you brought them back. It's the same.
Yeah, that stupid fucking hat you have.
What's up?
Better get rid of that stupid hat.
I know. Looks like a Czechoslovakian refugee.
What if he's gonna wear that playing baseball?
Fucking thing up.
I burned the door. Basically against the door. You can. You've got the other way. You're not gonna get much more. Okay, because she maxed out on you. You've got enough here that you can start. That's the with the tool. Remember, you
just slip that over this door edge.
Tighten it up. Take the whole unit. Just push against it. Open it up. Now you've got a halfway decent opening that you can get at. Start. Got that into your leg a little bit, right? Nader bolt. A lot of times it'll work better to go above it or below it. Most of the time it'll work. Even if it tears on you, you want to be able to make room in there to be able to spread. Use spreads of this. Okay? Now, once you can get your tool in up to this part, now start making your 32-inch spread if you have to go that distance. But he was doing it right. He just wasn't 100% sure exactly where he wanted to make his spread. He was trying right on the bolt, and it kept on just sliding back on him a little bit. He went above right away. She started working. Okay. Side, so you can see.
I don't know, I just want
okay. See, there you go. The door's gonna go down, so nice and easy. Nice and easy. Now, stop wheel. It had problems, it keeps tearing. Not really, but it keeps tearing. He can't spread it anymore. We'll get the cutter, we'll cut it. Open it up just a little bit.
I'm trying to teach you to leave it tips full with stress on it. And crank the balls tight. You've got stress on it. Wipe the stress on it. Now, let's go right around here. And don't try and hold this because it's going to go where it wants to go. This one right here. I want this one right there. Open it up enough so you can take it. That's it. No. Times, okay? Now you just take and lay that right onto here. He can see what he's doing here, okay? Just lift it up. All right, now I'm going to get out. He's going to lift up on it. I don't recommend anything. This is the way I like the best. Okay? You have pulled steering columns before, right?
Yeah. All
right, now watch now. Watch how nice. Take your hand away from there. All you're gonna do is have it there to control it. And your control handle now. I want it nice and easy to cut. Possibly. You might have the first aid for sure. Okay. Why don't you come right just like you have it. only have this much to go up. You still know that you're going to have to go up. Oh, you can come right over here, make a cut here, and over there before you make the spread, and take that rib right out of it. If you have to, you can make a cut right across here, right here, take that right out of it. When you come back down, put her in neutral. Now, there's quite a bit of tension on there, right? Right here. You want it right against the top there. Off. Lay it flat. There you go. Grab it. There you go. Pick that up out. There you go. Now, here's what a feathering helps for a simple reason. You got a person in here with a whiplash or something. You want to try and move it as easy as you can. Have your first aid people taking care of them. Most of you guys do your own first aid. All right, you know, you'll watch, you'll see. Most of the time, the seats will jump. Try and prepare your victim. Just for that little bit of movement with your collar and everything else. But you try and keep them from getting that job. Just to show them what it'll do. At an accident, you want to go this slow.
It's a Ford.
Nice car. Nice car. Now, probably your best way to be would be to block it. And have to get cribbing. Put cribbing in here. Work it. Take it to the other side, see if the other side of the car will wait. Now, you might develop 10 different alternatives. She wanted to go her own way. Just let her go her own way.
Okay, that's loose there.
Cut there. Big one cut right here. Okay, I go to the other side. Thank you.
bounced off the camera.
Huh?
It bounced off the camera.
Did it?
Yeah, hit right here.
It was a safety call. But he didn't get right out of there if you have to. So you reach right in and cut it right in place. Now, if you want, cut the steering columns, the tool does it. Old questions asked. Steering wheel flying, back.
Smile.
Shaft.
Okay,
steering,
good smile.
Steering wheel. All right, you've got not caught on something that who knows what's there, but that's they're not trying to point to.
So you can try to get that deep paint right in the water.
Alka Creek has these. I sold them.
Well, when are you going to show us how to work that thing?
Anytime you want me to.
Wheels, and I want them to be exactly centered side to side. Okay? Probably won't hurt them. Okay, now, the one in front. I'm sorry, your name is?
Steve.
Please do me a favor and flip the bag upside down so that the nipple is pointed out towards you, so it's not underneath the truck. By the way, there is no difference between the top and the bottom of an airbag. Top and the bottom are both constructed the same. The only difference is that they decided to put the yellow little spec sheet on one side because
yeah,
it was
right
less expensive
the
than putting
trend.
It on two sides.
That's good, right there.
Okay, gentlemen, are we ready?
Yep.
Okay. We would like our operator to inflate both simultaneously, please. Do we have the system turned on? Did you turn this on? There we go. Okay, now, are we cranked up to about 145 here? Okay. Okay, very good.
Good.
Now you can inflate.
Good job.
Yeah, go full gun. We'll go. Oh, excuse me. Could we stop for a minute, please? Would somebody like to chalk the front wheels? It'd be kind of embarrassing if we rolled your truck down the driveway, you know. Little things like that.
Quick's found out the truck rolls racks.
Okay. Continue. Thank you. We'll get that fixed in a heartbeat. Okay, I think that you're probably high enough off the ground that you can, while you're changing bottles, we'll get the other bag in place. Okay, what's your skinniest bag that you've got? 13? Okay, you've got an extra hose, I believe.
Yes.
Okay, let's grab the extra green hose. Give this to the training officer, that's his job.
Okay,
hook up the green hose to this bag. Hold on, you gotta hook your hose up. Okay, now.
Torch boy, pull those boots up.
Once that's in.
As far as we can get it. That's close enough. Okay, was there a question?
What's that little bag gonna do now?
What we're gonna do, we're gonna disconnect one of those hoses, and we're gonna hook up the hose on this little bag and inflate it. What this basically is meant to show you is that even though you don't have a space to get a bag under something, that doesn't mean you can't lift it. That means if you've got 1 inch to work with anywhere on the surface that needs to be lifted, you can get something underneath it and wedge it enough to get a full bag under where you need it. Does that make sense? Do you all know what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. Like if you have a car flipped over in a ditch, and you only have a corner of it, you need it. Push, push. There you go. Okay, inflate the green bag. The new green bag. Now, if that gets to be too much pressure, hand it to somebody else.
No, don't do that.
Okay, does everybody understand what we've done here?
Can't change the tire then.
And let's hope that we did this evenly enough that we can get the bag out. Otherwise, we got to drive the truck off the bag. Okay.
How do you think Captain Murray got up in
here? Pretty good.
The box will relieve itself right here, and as fast as the air flows into it, it will flow out of it.
Because I get it just a little bit over. I don't want to do anything yet. I didn't feel it.
Probably, right. What happens is over 116, it will start to relieve itself until it comes back to the loop. Okay? We'll do that with these because we're going to have enough of a load on it that you'll be able to relieve it pretty quickly.
Because I tell you, you know, I was watching the bag, and I watched the gate, and I looked on it. I got to stay out there.
How we do?
Wonderful.
Okay, are we ready? Are the wheels chalked? Okay, now what you want to do? Yeah, it's really embarrassing when we roll a truck. Let me tell you. Okay, whoever's going to be the watcher. We'd like you to watch. We only got one bag under there. Where'd he go? What's the training officer's name? Come on, you guys, volunteer.
Great. Take it down a second.
Steam CSI will definitely rupture your building. Oh, my goodness.
Are you going to affect if I put my helmet on?
Yeah, I see daylight.
There's daylight on that side.
Daylight on this side.
Oh, did it relieve itself?
Yeah.
Are you still inflating?
No. Call off.
It relieved itself so far, huh?
call left and we're taking it out.
I don't know.
Might have been a max.
No, keep going. It'll relieve itself when it gets to the
right.
What is the weight of your fire truck? You got a load of water in it?
Find out.
How much did your fire truck weigh, guys?
Heavy.
We have our permits.
That'll tell you.
How many tons?
21,600.
What?
Okay.
21,600 on the rear axle.
Thank you, Mr. Wizard.
21,600.
You've got a
with
pound
water.
Scale.
With what? What are you doing?
Yeah. Only that bass he caught Saturday weighed the same.
Okay.
11 tons.
That's the weight. Right. Okay. I can't tell, but you probably got it, what, about 6-7 inches?
Yeah, about that.
Okay. Let's try and see if we can deflate it and get the other bag under there.
Okay, you take out the 4-inch.
Okay,
cut down, break down.
Get it there.
Steve,
yeah.
Whatever,
purchase
yourself.
We
put
the
4 inches.
Take one of your small bags. Keep your pen bag.
Light in there.
These will each go up about 7 inches, 6 inches. Wonderful. Take a little bit more closer to you, Steve. Pull the bottom one.
On the bottom one?
Yep. Henry, move your side towards him, too. I'm going to ask Henry to push it a little more towards you. Okay.
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 In case one of our firemen fall in.
Yeah, right.
Okay, now it's like your bottom bag.
Pool or something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. You got a load of water on it.
We don't know.
That's what you
have. Drain the tank. Drain the tank, basketball. Dump it.
Yeah, you can do that. Okay, you want to try that? If you take both your bags side by side, you put them both up, you're going to get twice the lift in the
air. I don't think you can do that, Trevor.
You know, we almost ran out of cribbing already. Marshall? We're almost out of cribbing.
I don't think you're going to be able to pull side by side.
There is an advantage to it. No, I want to make
it. You know, I can always crank this up higher.
Okay.
Where's Franny?
Six.
Yellow or green?
Okay, hold on.
Hold on, you gotta go to yellow again.
Let's check. Is it
all right, now hang on a second.
Oh, Marshall, you didn't do it again.
I'm shaking for my kids. Okay. Oh, so.
You were busy.
Take it easy. Hang on.
Take a bus.
Get in the back wheels or what?
Okay, take it slow though.
Why are the front wheels checked?
We're lifting those off the ground.
We're moving?
Coming out. We have liftoff.
Contact Houston.
We're lifting. Sliding.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sound.
Okay, and you can change the tires now, man.
Hey, the other side's way off.
Not okay. Our job.
Hold it. That's it.
That's good.
Okay.
He's out of control.
He loves it.
He's
going. He's the game. 2,000 points.
That's
2,500.
That's why they call them joysticks.
I'm not giving him enough.
It's going to relieve itself.
That's pretty hot.
He's got a cough.
Wait.
Hurry up.
Get up there, Bill.
Make sure you get the...
Well, they yeah, look like you're straining a little, Bill.
Still working out of Haney's?
Yeah. The big workout.
Quick, change the tire.
I like those biceps, Bill.
Six ratings jump that line.
Did anybody else want to climb under there and do this?
Yeah. Sure.
Why not?
Low light level?
Huh?
Low light level?
I could take this with seven lights. Seven lux.
But you see that shiny paint in the background?
No.
You got better than the Silhouette there?
Quicker than two bags.
No.
I love you have to take the second one real slow.
What a slob.
Fire on.
Nothing says we can't go from the other side either.
You know. Are they using the spreader?
Yeah.
Yep.
We got that door.
You already had the spreaders on.
Huh?
Yeah. Okay.
The seats are awfully strong. Can you stick a wedge between them?
Get it up, get them out. What do you need?
Got a backboard for this station?
Not supposed to fit here.
Backboard.
Okay, right there.
Yep, three of them.
Where's he supposed to be trapped?
Right underneath the steering wheel. Like.
Underneath the steering wheel?
I mean, in between the steering wheel and the seat.
Oh.
Okay, now.
Hi there.
Hey Jim.
Hey.
I wonder if you guys didn't build the bots.
Huh?
I didn't build the bots.
Majority of the big people were plus it needed something to be so much left here.
So we don't have enough room.
Part of the diplomat club, can't understand that extrication is a serious business.
Why is that, Jim?
Well, those people that actually own diplomats, we know the reason behind it. It's very tricky business.
Steve, what's the time?
The big one? How does it work?
Rough.
Well, how about the window?
I forgot all about it.
You want to see if he had Jared or Jared? Scratch his panties. Where's the college?
Scratch the room. Everybody in there?
Yo, mama. You brought your own smokes.
Is anybody in here?
For
it.
No, I have no idea. It's America.
Be Christopher. Yeah, fine.
Yeah, 28.
You got some purple. Okay, overall, I think you did a real good job. We started off with Mike was in charge of the car that was flipped all the way over. Mike Zatino was in charge of the car that was flipped on its side.
Quicks.
Well, you and Quicks worked together. That was real good.
Roger and Jerry. Me, Roger, and Jerry were
No smoking in the truck's coming in. Five was spotted real good. Just a reminder for five, when five comes in, the majority of the equipment is on the driver's side. Initially, we had to come in and we turned it around. I thought that was a good move. So, drivers, keep in mind if we ever. Driver's side problem would be best towards the scenes because most of our tools are there.
Yeah, every action circle, you gotta stay back apart. You pulled in too close.
Yeah. We gotta leave enough room to work and to bring tools in. As far as taking the tools off, they all came off real good. You gotta remember, you never know what kind of tools you're gonna need, so it's best just to take everything that you might think you might need.
You can open up the toolboxes.
To use. You're gonna know right away, you're gonna be using, the toolboxes and a lot of equipment in it. Of course, the spreaders, the power unit. At one point, we used the jaws and the cutters, and it was one point in time where we really could use a larger unit, a quad unit. So we used tools, working with two tools inside of the room. So looking into more tools. We used three for stabilization. We might have to do that until we get Jackson. So we'll always keep that in mind. That was a good idea to start that. Cribbing cars work real good. I think we could use just a little bit more cribbing. Larger pieces.
And a trailer.
Especially, if we ever have a trailer. And the larger pieces, filling up boxes, if the car was flipped over, we had to raise the back or raise the front. The bigger pieces work well for that instead of using little pieces. One thing I noticed, we used a, the power unit, we put an extra length of line in there. With that type of power unit, we could move that basically right up close to the car.
Well, that was...
All that line did was just make a mess.
It's what happened there is they were hooking it up on the other side. We were ready over there, so we brought it around. They already had one end hooked up to the cutters already, so we just hooked it up instead of disconnecting it. That's why.
So I'm not saying it's a bad idea, but in that type of situation that we had here, the cars are real close to each other. I don't think there was a need for a second line on there. The first victim came out in 6 minutes. Not bad. The second victim came out in 11 minutes. Third victim, 25. And the fourth victim, 32 minutes. One thing we got to remember is if you have using a tool and you're done using the tool.
That could be all that shot out too.
The problem is on this one.
The problem that we're running into.
You gotta speak up. Hold it.
One, you can't cut through the bolt. We tried it with the Ajax tool, which is no good.
No.
We did try it. We tried cutting around the bolt that holds the seat down, but the problem that you run into is if you run into a frame, your top bolt on the quarter panel here, you can't get it back. So the only thing you'd be able to do is get your inside bolts.
Okay, impossible access from the inside.
Where you were at with that thing kind of coming up, you know, you would have been all set. See what I was saying on that, Michael?
Yeah.
Because even if he started spreading it, he could have started it, and if it looked like it was ripping through or whatnot, you could have stopped and pulled the person out, because I still think that would have lifted that seat up.
I think it would have.
Yeah.
Minute and 7 seconds. Pop it off.
How much, Jim?
Minute and 7.
See this?
Yeah.
Hey, look at the chain there. You got a chain?
Do after you ram her.
Spread it.
Ram. Well, what do you do after?